Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about diffusion. I'm going to do a two or three part series on diffusion because there seems to be a lot of misunderstanding out there. So we're going to talk about quadratic diffusion in particular and walk you through some of the basics. The first thing we have to distinguish is between actual diffusion and sound redirection. There's a lot of products in the marketplace that call themselves diffusers, but diffusers must satisfy six real stringent conditions within your room, and we'll get into those in the next video. But for purposes of this video, we're going to talk about quadratic diffusion because it's the true diffusion. It actually satisfies all six of those criteria. So we really need to be careful out there. I see some acoustic product manufacturers have foam, and they're calling it a foam diffuser. Here you go. So let's walk through some of the basics and you can see why I find some of it amusing and sometimes it pisses me off. But anyway, the bottom line here is quadratic diffusion is really the only true diffuser. What is it? We've all seen it. It's a series of wells or troughs with real thin dividers between each well or trough. That's what the spaces between each divider are called. The thinner the divider, the better. For practical purposes, you know, they should be about an eighth inch thick or an eighth inch wide on the dividers, but that's difficult to find small wood that size. So quarter inch is what we use on all our projects, seems to work really very well and stays true. Quadratic diffusion, each well depth is calculated at 1/4 wavelength for the depth. Each well width here is calculated at 1/2 wavelength. So you have a little bit of flexibility in width and obviously in depth. This is based on prime number 7. All diffusers are based on some prime. It's this particular series is developed by a modular formula where you plug in a constant factor, subtract it, and then take the residue from that equation. That's where they get their name, residue diffusers. It's based on the calculation of the series of wells or troughs within it. This one's based on prime number 7, so we have a 1-4-2-2-4-1. Now, what does all that mean? Well, we can do a little calculating. We can know that this is based on 1/4 wavelength, the depth, so if it's 4 inches, then we know times 4 is going to give us 16 inches. Okay, about a foot, foot and a quarter. We take the speed of sound, 1130, and we divide it by 1.25 feet because they're both in feet, you're going to get what, about 900? So this 4-inch depth represents about 900 cycles. Sound enters this, bounces around inside the little well or trough, and then re-exits out the front. Now, it returns in the same magnitude, the same strength, so that's good. We do have a little phase delay here because we have wells that have different depths. So the energy has to travel different distances. So when it comes out, that's the reason for the distance from a particular prime number sequence sitting far enough away that we can realize the full waveform of finding itself and expanding itself and living, if you will, the proper dimensions. So there's distances from diffusers that we have to sit. So in summary, it's a series of wells or troughs. It's a true diffuser, and we have to distinguish between redirected or redirection and actual diffusion. Then we have quadratic diffusion, which is the true diffuser with the wells based on 1/2 and 1/4 wavelength. In the next series, we'll talk a little bit about the criteria that a true diffuser has to have. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed today's video. If you did, give me a thumbs up so I know that it had value to you. And please, if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section and I'll be more than happy to answer them for you. Alternatively, if there are other topics that you wish to discuss or see discussed in a video presentation, send me an email, info@acousticfields.com, and we'll get them on our list and get them done for you. I release a new video about every week, so stay tuned to our YouTube channel and keep updated on our new videos.